Welcome to another video from far north, Bushcraft and Survival. My name is Lonnie. Behind the camera is my lovely wife Connie, and we're out here camping in our UP2 tent from Russian Bear Market at least one last time before the winter is over. We experienced some cold outside, and we have some good food and some good company with each other. So I hope you come along with us, and let's get started. Connie's fixing us some supper. So what are you fixing us?
Oh, just some Spanish rice. Gonna put some Spam in it. And just some fried potatoes.
Fried potatoes on the side?
Yep, separate.
Sounds good. I'm looking forward to it. You know, because we're using cots in here, the cots kind of take up a lot of extra room. So, we do have this one chair set up, and I put tennis balls on the bottom of the legs to give it flotation on the snow, and that really works great. But, I'm using my stadium seat again in here, and I'm impressed how well this works. You know, it is sitting on my cot, so it doesn't take up any extra room.
Starting to brown up good.
Well, you sleep good.
Good night.
Good night. See you in the morning. Well, good morning. It's shortly after 8 o'clock in the morning. We turned the stove up. It's getting warm in here. And we're thinking about getting up and meeting the day. Well, we slept great last night. We sweated all night. Here's our thermometer. It says it's 7 degrees Fahrenheit, and it's 74 inside here, it says. So that would be 14 below Celsius and 24 above Celsius. Okay, now, last night, the coldest was 26 below Celsius and 6 above Celsius inside here. Okay, let's switch back to Fahrenheit. The coldest it was last night. Oh, let's see here. Yeah, 16 below Fahrenheit and 42 degrees inside here. See, all night long we had the stove turned down as cold as it would go, which is the way we've got it set right now. And I guess you can't see much. You see a little bit of glow in there. That's the way we ran the stove all night long. And this tent is so well insulated with because of the inner layer and the outer layer, the two layers. Boy, it was nice in here. I wanted to show you a little handy thing that I made a while back. Okay, this is just a piece of vinyl tubing with a short piece of
of harder plastic tubing inside. And what I did that for, here's my spoon and fork from my mess kit. And I shove this in there. And I shove this in there. And now I have some tongs to use. Making the spoon and the fork multi-purpose.
Here's Lonnie's homemade tongs in action. They work great. For breakfast this morning, we're going to make some breakfast burritos. So in the baking grease that was in my skillet, I've added green and red pepper. And now I'm going to add fresh mushrooms and onions that I already had pre-cut up from home. And then we'll fry that up and get those sauteed before we add the eggs.
Our Spanish rice we had last night, that was in part inspired by who? What were you going to say?
Oh, Muskrat Jim, a channel that Lonnie's been subscribed to for years. He's a YouTube friend of ours, and he just recently had a cookout, and he used that same Spanish rice but made it into a completely different recipe. And so you might want to check out his video, Muskrat Jim.
As Connie is cooking breakfast on the stove here, she had something else she wanted to show you.
The tortillas were a little cool, so I'm going to put them up here in this netting. And I also have my butter up here, keep it soft. The same netting that we dry our gloves, it's, you know, up here in the ceiling, so it's nice and warm up here. So that helps warm things up food-wise, too.
Okay, so as she's cooking breakfast, it's time I need to throw in another log. Yeah, we got a good coal base in there, so that should be good for right now. Alright. Connie's got the air intake off right now, so that it'll get to burning real good. We were just outside for a little bit and it got cold in here. Well, Connie's cooking here. We got the coffee percolating. And because she's got the stove turned up, let's see, you got any? We'll show the flames from the other side. We pulled the door out of its pocket so that it's just resting here so air can come in around the door, and we opened one window here so that air can flow in from the bottom and out through the top, and that helps keep it a little moderated in here while we got the stove turned up. And I wanted to show you this pepper and salt setup. These are old 35 millimeter film containers, and you used to be able to buy those tops for them. This set's probably over 30 years old, but we're still using them.
Okay, Connie's putting the final touches on our breakfast burritos. She said that if we show these with mayonnaise on them, it might gross some people out. But hey, that's how we like them. So if it grosses you out, sorry. We do enjoy it.
And you can always, instead of mayonnaise, you can do your sour cream or your taco sauce or whatever you like on them. We even have this little bitty glass bottle of Tabasco that we got out of a old MRE kit.
Okay, well now I've got two choices. I can continue videoing, or I can eat a breakfast burrito. Sorry, guys, I guess you know which choice I made. You may have heard people say that it's very peaceful, very enjoyable to winter camp. Don't believe a word of it. It is tough. It is hardcore. Notice how hard Connie is working right here. She is just working up a sweat. We're pulling down the tent now, getting ready to head out back to home. And I thought I might share a tip with you. When pulling stakes during the winter, they tend to freeze in and they can be a bear. They can be difficult to get out. Here's a little tip. Just give it a tap down. And then that loosens it up. That breaks the bond of the freezing and it enables you to pull it out. Thank you for joining Connie and I on this camping trip. I hope you enjoyed it. We'll see you folks on the next video. You take care. Have a good one. If you enjoyed this video, be sure and give it a thumbs up and to share it, as well as subscribe so you don't miss any more. And check out these suggested videos here. Thank you.